Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the HTTP 422 error. If you see an HTTP 422 error, it means the server understands your request, but it can't fulfill it due to a problem on your end. In this video, we'll talk about what causes the 422 error and how to troubleshoot it if you're using WordPress. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what actually causes the 422 error? Typically, the HTTP 422 code pops up when there's a semantic error in the contents of a request. If you're using WordPress, that usually means one of two things. Number one, one of the files involved in the request contains code with semantic errors. To put it another way, there's an error somewhere in the code. Number two, you're dealing with a corrupt database table. One problem with error 422 is that there's no way of knowing what its cause is at first glance. This means you may need to try more than one troubleshooting method until you arrive at the problem. In some cases, tables within the WordPress database might become corrupted during an update. This means that if you're updating a plugin, theme, or WordPress itself, and the process is interrupted, database entries can start presenting errors. A corrupt database can lead to all sorts of errors within WordPress, such as pages not loading, features not working correctly, and HTTP code such as 422. There are two ways to repair a corrupted WordPress database. The easiest approach is to use a plugin such as WPDB Manager. Once you activate WPDB Manager, you'll get access to a new database tab in the dashboard. Go to Database and then Repair DB and select the tables that you want to repair. Since you may not know which table is corrupt, select them all and then click on Repair. The process should only take a few seconds and you'll see a success message when it's ready. Now, try accessing the page that returned the 422 error to see if it persists. If you don't have access to the WordPress admin due to the 422 error, you can repair the database manually. To do so, you'll need to access the database from your hosting control panel. If you use Kinsta, you can access the database from your My Kinsta dashboard. Select a website and go to the Info tab. Look for the Database Access section, where you'll find the login credentials for the database. Click on Open PHP My Admin and enter those credentials. Select the database you want to repair from the menu to the left, and you'll see a breakdown of all the tables it contains to the right. Use the Check All option at the bottom of the page to select every table. Then, look for the Repair Table option in the menu to the right. Click on the Go button and wait for PHP My Admin to return a success message. Now, go ahead and check if the HTTP 422 error persists. If repairing the database doesn't make the error go away, the problem lies with one of the WordPress files. Since every WordPress installation contains dozens to hundreds of files, it's not feasible to check all of them for semantic code errors. Your best bet in this scenario is to enable the WordPress debug feature, which will give you access to error logs. To enable the WordPress debug mode manually, you'll need to edit the wp-config.php file in the root directory. You can do that by accessing your website via an FTP client and locating the wp-config.php file. Open the file and add the following two lines of code before the line that says, "That's all, stop editing. Happy blogging." If the WP debug line already exists, make sure that it reads true and simply add the second line of code. Save the changes to the file and reload the page that returns the 422 error. The error should persist, but now you have access to error logs. To read those logs, navigate to the WP content folder inside the root directory and look for the debug.log file. You can open the file using a text editor. If the file is new, it should only contain a few lines, one of which should refer to the error that's causing the 422 code. The error should point you towards a specific file that's causing the problem. It should also include information about which line within the file contains a semantic error. If you use Kinsta, you don't have to enable the WordPress debug mode or error logs manually. Instead, go to My Kinsta, select your website, and jump to the Tools tab. Inside, you'll find an option for enabling WordPress debugging. After enabling debugging, you can go to the Logs tab and select the Error.log option. My Kinsta will display the latest errors on your website, and the viewer includes a search feature to help you find specific entries. Focusing on the latest entry should help you identify which file is causing the 422 error. Once you identify the file, you can try and fix the semantic error or replace it with a stock version from WordPress. With Kinsta, troubleshooting errors is much easier. Our My Kinsta dashboard includes built-in tools for debugging WordPress. If you don't want to troubleshoot issues manually, you can always reach out to our support team. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to find more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.